So anyway, say you would like to price a CDS on a firm UL. So what will happen, of course, is since we have this underlying Markov structure, all prices of basic instruments will be representable as certain functions of the state. But for vanilla instruments, we can be more precise. We can give explicit formulas. So this is a dynamic version of the usual time zero price for a CDS. So one minus recovery multiplied by one minus G means basically probability of default before maturity, except that now it is dynamic, so it is conditional probability of default before maturity. So this prices the protection leg at any point in time, and that's minus the premium leg, which is spread, so contractual spread, multiplied by integrated future probabilities that the reference name is still alive at that time. Okay, so tau L greater than S. Okay, so this is the formula, and this is model independent. But what we have in this very case is that we know explicit formulas for these conditional survival probabilities. And by the way, a funny thing is that even you, if you consider a given name L fixed in this model, these conditional probabilities, since they are computed given the big GT, also depend on other guys. Okay, so this is realistic in the sense that if you believe in contagion, etc., even if you focus on CNS on one guy, the fact that there are other people floating around should impact your pricing. And this is what happens here. So this is an effect of non-immersion. You cannot view someone in isolation in the model. Okay? It is impacted by others, even if it's product only on that guy, which is good and bad. I mean, we were saying that we wanted a model without immersion, so this is what happens. So that's good. Okay? But what we lose, of course, is the possibility to view a CDS on a name as a system affecting only that name. It means it will be also more complex numerically. Okay? And also, it would be a bit surprising if, in numerical terms, numerically, the impact of the other guys was first order. I mean, intuitively, we are ready to accept that there could be some impact. I mean, theoretically speaking, economically speaking, there could be some impact of other people. But at first order, I mean, it should mainly be a matter of name L. So we'll see in the numerics if the impact of the other people on the matter of pricing CDS of name L is second order, as we expect. Okay. So pricing is one thing, but we want to do some true dynamic things like simply valuing counterparty risk on CDS. For that, the understanding of the, and also edging, of the structure of the martingale parts of the prices is key, because edging basically means offsetting martingale parts between different products. Okay? And in fact, what matters is, well, what the martingale part for C is essentially what is called the cumulative price of the CDS, so price plus all accumulated past dividends. That's how you retrieve the martingale part of C. And in that case, it is, well, once you noted that the price is a function of a certain combination of risk factors, which are Markov, the structure of the martingale part of C can only be integrands of the Brownian motions. So excuse me, this theta should be k here. Okay. Number k can only be the derivative of the function CL with respect to MK amplified by the volatility of W key in the factor number k, which was this MK, dmk was sigma t dwk. So again, once you know the model is Markov, it's very useful because you don't have you don't even have to demonstrate that. It becomes obvious. I mean, you know that in a Markov model, the structure of the martingale part is such that the coefficients of the W are simply the gradient of the function. Okay. And the coefficients of the compensated jump to default terms have to be, so if it is a default of name L, it has to be value after the cumulative value after name L, which is simply 1 minus recovery, minus so-called pre-default value, which is priced right before theta. And if we are pricing name L, but we are looking the martingale component in the direction of the compensated default of name J different L, the coefficient can only be the jump of CL in response of a default of name J, which means with the same notation, this delta J operator of CL valued at that point. So here again, the Markov structure is used to establish this formula, which is important to know what are the relevant Greeks that you need to compute in order to edge yourself.